Hello, brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. I want to share my latest dream that I got on July 29, 2020. The scene in the first part of this dream is like in the fairy tale or movie. In the dream, I saw a mother and two daughters. They sat under a tree talking to each other. Then suddenly a large double door appeared in front of them. The door opened and a bright white light came out of the door. The mother and her two daughters entered the door. There is a voice in my spirit saying like when they enter, they won't come back easily. It's like in the Jumanji movie. I felt that door was the door to another world. Then I was taken to see what happened to the mother and her two daughters after they entered the door. I was in a room like a theater, and I felt they were there too. No other people in the room, only the lady and two daughters and a man. It seems like there are other stories too in this dream, but I can't recall it when I woke up. What I remember is that I saw her first daughter. She was wearing a light blue party dress like Cinderella. Her hair was blonde and looked beautiful. She sang a worship song with that man. In the spirit, I feel that man is Jesus. And the voice of this princess is so good. Then the second princess also sang with that man. I saw her wearing a pink party dress, but the voice of the second princess was not as good as the first princess. Then I was taken to another scene, but I still feel like I was in that door. It's like I was in my house where I live now, but the house seems rather different and bigger. I feel everything in this house is new and looks perfect. All the furniture and all things in this house were replaced with the new ones. I didn't see it, but I feel it in the spirit. The atmosphere is very peaceful, safe and secure, and I feel so full, and it seems like everything I want is fulfilled. All the things in this house are all new and perfect without defects, as if the old one was replaced by the new one. It's the feeling of contentment that I never feel before and can be explained with the words. I also felt like I was there only temporary and that I will return to the real world. I felt like my family members were there too, but I didn't see them clearly, only saw one of my younger brother. Brothers and sisters in Christ, from this dream I feel like God take me to experience the heavenly realm. That door is the door to heaven. The two daughters symbolize the bride of Christ because I saw them wearing the party dress. The man in the theater is Jesus. In heaven, we will worship Jesus. So the first message for us is we need to do praise and worship too in our daily life. It will strengthen our spirit. And from the second scene, I saw all things in my house are new and perfect. The scripture that come to my mind when I think about this is Revelation 21 verse 5. Behold, I make all things new. Behold, I make all things new. Brothers and sisters can read Revelation 21 more detail. It is about the new heaven and earth. Here we will read from verse 5 to 8. Verse 5. And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burns with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. Brothers and sisters in Christ, it doesn't matter if in this world we don't have much wealth. As long as we live according to the word of God, we pray and seek Him diligently, we will inherit great things in heaven. So there is a reward for those that are faithful. This is God's promise to us that overcome. One day we will be with Him in heaven and New Jerusalem. So no matter how difficult our lives, do not let go our faith in Jesus and keep walking in the narrow path. Our suffering in this world is temporary, but we will forever in heaven with Jesus. Matthew 7:13-14, the narrow and wide gates. Enter through the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leads to destruction, and many enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow the road that leads to life, and only a few find it. So which way that we choose, narrow way to heaven or broad way to hell? Broad way is so easy and simple. We can compromise to sin and live like whatever we like. Following Jesus is not an easy way, full of challenge. But we see and experience Jesus in it, and in the end, we will have eternal life that is promised to us. All the story of the saints in the Bible showed us that their life is not easy. Joseph was being sold by his brothers and put in jail. Daniel was thrown into the lion's den, and many other stories. So let us continue living for Jesus, crucify our flesh and led by the Spirit. Jesus is the only way to heaven, and He is coming soon. We don't have much time anymore, so get right with Him now. Don't delay and obey His commandments, because He come for the spotless bride. That's all I like to share, brothers and sisters. Hope this could encourage us. If you have any comments, can share it in the comment section below. And if you need prayer, you can send email to me. May Jesus, our Lord and Savior, bless us all and keep us safe. Love you all, brothers and sisters, and thank you for listening. Bye.